a dirty old Epiphone Joe Pass. And man, is it, it's pretty dirty. Looks like it's been sitting around for a while. And the neck's got a arched back. So let's uncover the truss rod and see if it actually works. Because the guitar is pretty tight right now. I should have videotaped the sound that this guitar just made. It sounded like a 2x4 freaking cracking. Oh god. Nice! The truss rod was pinned! What's the frets look like on this? Well, it needs fret work. These are munched. And it needs the big cleanup. And somebody said this switch ain't working either. Let's plug it in. Okay, it's gonna live. The truss rod works, and I just checked the switch. I don't hear anything wrong with it. It's missing its knobulator. But it sure is gooey and filthy, and the pickups look awful. The fretboard's dried up like the frickin' Gobi Desert. Okay. Well, I'm gonna clean it all up tomorrow. Fix up the frets. Get all that denty shit out of there. We should be good to go. Alrighty. Epiphone. Joel Pass. Doubt. Where is it? Joe Pass, Doubt. Okay. Cheers, folks. I'll do a little more when I actually clean it up. Well, let's clean up Joe Pass and dress the frets. There was a comment somebody was asking me about the neck straightness. When you level fretboard, neck must be as perfectly straight as possible, which requires adjusting the truss rod after the string tension has been released. So, just a little tidbit there, you know. Tidbits of information. It just drools out of the corner of my mouth on a daily basis. Okay, here we go again. More fun. On a Sunday. On another shitty, crappy, rainy Sunday. This thing is just covered in shit. Look. Look. Is this gonna pop off for me? Oh, look at that. Come on, honey. As opposed to falling off and scratching the front of the guitar. Bastards. Oh, look. I found my remote control. Super cool, kind of a pickguard. Epiphone don't do anything like that anymore, no doubt. It's a 14. I don't have a block for a 14, a radius block, so I'm gonna use the beam. Okay. So everything gets blue. Once again, the old blue marker. And I gotta find the beam. Where the hell is it? It's over there somewhere, I think. Somewhere around there. Found it. I like to remove the nut. And I'll show you how I do that. I heard the greatest, this is a funny musician joke, man, and I thought I'd heard them all. Okay, so the buddies are auditioning guitar players, and the bass player says, "That guy played guitar like he was in jail." And the drummer says, "What do you mean? Like, you play guitar like he's in jail?" That's how you take out the nut. "Guy plays guitar like he's in jail." "What do you mean?" "Like, he's behind a few bars and can't find a key." Okay, so with the nut out of the way, that'll allow me to... this sucks, this camera angle. It'll allow me to level right off the edge into space. And then we'll put that back on after. Okay, let's grind the shit out of these things. Always remember to take a minute and protect your magnetic giblets there from the filings we're going to create. And I also like to have the sandpaper like a bit used. And if I had to put a new piece, like we're not pushing this down. I guess I should tell you about the beam. This is actually filled with rice to give it some weight. Some guys fill it with sand, but this has got enough of its own. We're just gonna guide it across. That gives us a big set of flat frets. All right, tendonitis to the rescue. Frickin' crap. I need to find my coffee. The entire time I'm doing this, I'm dreaming about a faster way to do this. And I've been dreaming about that for a long time. And you know what? There is no fast way to do this. It's just the way she goes. Yeah, okay, so Stumac sells these guys, right? Yeah. The protectors. And then you'll see guys that tape everything. You know, tape off every fret. And then, you know, then you're using this thing. Well, here's Dave's invention. If you put a couple of tape wings on either side of this, and just move yourself along there. Anyhow. Different strokes for different jokes. Oh, hey, did I mention my new boss has an Academy Award in special effects? That's the kind of guy I want to hang around with instead of the usual fucking ding-dongs they set me up with. Whoa, no! The fretboard's not too frickin'. It's only sort of, it's not like brown suds today, it's just sort of gray suds. So, yeah. Whoa, man. Hey, there's a fretboard under there. That's a really nice pickguard. There was so much DNA on it, how could you tell? Yep, he played guitar like he was in jail. Okay, a little bit of never dull. I can tell that this guitar fretboard has never seen the light of any sort of conditioning or oil. It's looking pretty sweet now. This is a really nice guitar, actually, now that all the shit's getting cleaned off it. Okay, what's left? Reinstall the nut. Scratch my nuts. And, I gotta clean the shit off of those, too. This is really nice. Not all the crap's pulled off it. Notice the tape position for that, but you can see how it's left its mark for you. Okay, I gotta clean off the bench and get another battery for that stupid camera. And let's set up Joe Pass. And it's getting these. I don't know why. Yeah, it's getting these. It's gonna like these strings much better than 10s. Okay. Somebody's going to ask what I used to glue the nut back in. It's not crazy glue. It's not white glue. It's not Gorilla Glue. I used 2 little drops of good old Testor's model cement. Acrylic cement. Easily removed and holds like hell once it dries. Today's eraser is orange. Whoa. So at this point, you're sort of hoping you're out of it, but not. We got a 1 problem fret here up around the neck joint. That's a common thing, but you see, until all the strings were on it, yanking it all together and pulling everything together in this area, we wouldn't know. If you put the straight edge on it, it all looks perfect, and I leveled it perfect with a perfectly level sending beam, but when it all starts pulling together, so I gotta shave a little bit off there and screw around another 10 minutes. I'm gonna try and get this with just the crowning file. I don't want to make more work than I need to make for myself. I think I might win. And that's why don't throw away all those stupid pieces of sandpaper you had, like I just frickin' did, because now I need to use them again. I'll be dipping in the garbage. No dice. Ah, shit. It's a frickin' shit festival. Ah, if it was easy, everybody'd be doing it. Come on. Oh, you son of a sea cook. Ah! another remedy for that is to whack it with the fret hammer, which I just did. Now I'm going to recrown it, repolish it, and I think I might have won. So we corrected that, only to reveal that the next fret has a bump in it too. So to get it right, it's a little more than what you think. And when I got the guitar, it was way jacked up, and that's probably why, because it was buzzing around here and there was nothing they could do because of these high frets, so it could never play right. But it's gonna play right now. Oh, and the other bitch about this is this only reveals itself when it's tuned. Yeah, when I put the fret rocking machine on here with the strings loose, there's no high frets. So, live and learn. I think the camera always makes the string action look like shit. You can't really see how low that is to the deck. Ah, I got it, cripe. Just remember, they're all the same. They always bubble up around this neck joint after time, and depending what happens with the tongue extension. And so even after an entire fret leveling under string tension, we still needed to do some work around here because that's where a lot of stuff takes place. Okay, I quit. Time for dinner. Cheers, folks.